Is there a fine line between optimism and reality? Optimism and reality are the foundations of our futures. Imagine the first man looking upon a spark and wondering what potential power he held in the palms of his hands. What greatness can come from something so small yet so bright? However, simply watching the spark burn instead of feeding it fuel won't start a fire. Starting with the development of civilization, it has been man's dream to be the best. Our inner drive for success is what has allowed the human race to reign for centuries, and optimism was the first step. We need to do more than just dream if we are to continue advancing. We can see where optimism and reality draw the line by first igniting the spark by looking at yin and yang, second, fuel our fire with modern medicine, and finally, watch it burn bright as we see how a family's battle with cancer ignited my future. First, let's strike these two stones together as we look at yin and yang. Yin and yang is the belief of a coexistence between good and evil, dating back thousands of years ago to ancient China. This ideology can be seen in the comparison of optimism and reality, with the idea that both are connected and balanced. If reality were to lack optimism, we would not be here today. In fact, we wouldn't have been able to make that spark needed in order to progress. And without reality and optimism, we would have simply watched the spark burn out. Yin and yang still applies today, and is practiced in forms of Eastern medicine, such as Tai Chi, medicinal herbs, and acupuncture. But let us move away from that point. Eastern medicine uses optimism to catch that spark, to shape the mind, yet uses physical activity and medicinal plants to shape your body, truly using that fuel to start our fire. Second, let's continue to fuel our fire as we analyze modern medicine. Today's medicine is the most advanced it has ever been. Our inner drive for success has not only allowed us to prevail in the medical field, but blaze trails in our war against disease. However, today's medicine still has its limitations. The reality is, modern medicine fails to take a holistic approach. It takes more than medicine to truly cure someone of their ailment. Optimism has played an important role in our medical system. In fact, a more optimistic approach towards illness has been known to increase patient survival rates. According to a study labeled Attitude in Your Health, published May 2008 on harvard.edu, Dutch researchers tracked 545 men who were free of cardiovascular disease and cancer when evaluated for dispositional optimism. Over the next 15 years, the optimists were 55% less likely to die due to cardiovascular disease and cancer. It just goes to show that optimism and reality not only shape our futures, but push us towards it. And finally, let's watch it burn bright as we see how my family's battle with cancer ignited my future. My grandmother was diagnosed with stage 3 astrocytoma, a form of brain cancer, on December 22, 1999. Her cancer was untreatable at the time by common methods such as chemotherapy, so in an attempt to fight the disease, she traveled to Mexico to seek some forms of alternative medicine. My grandmother was optimistic. But once she was away from family and friends, her only company was my grandfather. And his lack of hope, as well as despair from the thought of losing his wife, fed into her worst fears, effectively snuffing out the spark of optimism and leaving pessimism in its place. Instead of the two looking towards their future, they focused on the past, and my grandmother was lost in time because of it. Though cancer may have taken my grandmother, it will never take away my memories. And because of my grandmother, and because of her battle, and because she pushed on, she has inspired me, she has ignited me to keep going. Because of my grandmother, I want to become a neurosurgeon, and I've pushed myself towards that goal ever since. Optimism has given me the spark, but I'll need to fuel it and light my own path. Now that we have ignited spark, fueled it, and watched the glowing fire, we can see how optimism and reality keep it burning. Reality without optimism is like life without oxygen. Both are needed to fuel thought, to spark thought and fuel change, for not only our fire to keep burning, but for our communities to progress. We must remember there is a fine line between optimism and reality, for one cannot work without the other. So next time you feel as if you're shrouded in darkness, always search for that spark, but never forget to fuel it and light.